Learn Excel for Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2165, Excel Golf Handicap. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. I was doing a seminar down in Fort Myers, Florida, and Andrew shows up in my session and said, hey, is there a way that I can figure out my golf handicap using Excel? He already has a column of all the golf scores over there in column A. He says, here's the thing. We want to take the last 20 rounds of golf and then find the 10 smallest scores in that last 20 and take the average of that. All right, so the average piece is easy. Even the last 20 piece is easy. Let's just say we had a min function here to find the smallest value. As I copy that formula down, it's automatically going to adjust, right? So it's always going to find the last 20. If the first one finds the last 20, then they're all going to find the last 20. And then the average is the easy piece. The part that's harder, though, is figuring out the second smallest, the third smallest, and the fourth smallest, and so on. All right, so I want to introduce a cool little function here called small. Min finds the smallest value, but small says we want to find, in this case, the second smallest value. So while 89 is the smallest value up there, the second smallest value is 91. What if there's a tie? It would do the right thing. So if we had, let's look at this once we get further in. If you had two that were 89, the smallest would be 89, the second smallest would be 89. All right, so it's going to work really well here. And so, of course, it would be tempting, although time-consuming, to write out a formula that says, all right, we want the first smallest, plus the second smallest, plus the third smallest, fourth, fifth, sixth, all the way, and then divide that whole thing by 10, like that, all right? And then just double-click to copy that down, and you'll see how your golf handicap changes over time. And let's just put together a string here where we put some really good golf scores, like 88s, all in a row, and you'll see that sure enough the golf handicap comes down. All right, but this would be time consuming to type that. Although it's easy to understand, time consuming. So what I'd rather use is a array constant. That's where we pass the small function, all 10 numbers all at once. And the way that I do this is I just start a little formula here and I point to the numbers 1 through 10. How'd you get the numbers 1 through 10? Well, that's easy. Put the number 1 in, hold down the control key while you grab the fill handle and drag, and you'll get the numbers 1 through 10. And then just anywhere equal, point to those 10 cells, but don't press enter. Instead, press F9 to calculate, and it selects, this is called an array constant. So open curly bracket, 1, semicolon, 2, semicolon, and so on. I can never remember that syntax. I always put the numbers 1 through 10 in, and then control C to copy that to the clipboard, press escape. Then over here, where the small function is asking for the smallest 1, select that number 1 and paste. And now what we're doing is asking for the smallest 10. This small function is going to return 10 answers, which is amazing, and then send the whole thing into the average function like that. Double click to copy it down, and it will work. All right, those are the kinds of tricks that are in this book, Power Excel with Mr. Excel. 617 Excel mystery solved. If you like this video, click that I in the top right hand corner. Take a look at buying that book. Wrap up today's episode. We have to calculate a golf handicap in Excel. So you get a list of your recent golf scores in Excel. And the handicap is the lowest 10 of the last 20 rounds. Well, the last 20 is easy thanks to Excel. We just go to row 20 and point at the last 20. And you could even get the smallest using min. But to get the second smallest through the 10th smallest, we can use the small function. So it would be slow but understandable to ask for the small comma 1, small plus small comma 2, plus small comma 3, that whole thing, and divide by 10. But instead, I'm going to use an array constant with all the numbers from 1 through 10 separated by semicolons inside the curly brackets, and that's going to become the second argument, small. This is going to return 10 values all at once, send those 10 values into the average function, and then my fast way for typing the array constant, first put a number 1 in, control drag, to get the numbers 1 through 10, and then point a formula to those 10 numbers and press F9, control C to copy the array constant onto the clipboard, and then you can paste it into your formula. All right, well, hey, I want to thank Andrew for showing up in my seminar, and I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.